Hi everyone, I'm Ivonne. I'm a Nederlander. I will a rude Pahalawak. I'm a vendela in Lanka. I'm a very sound to say me.
They think I'm white, I'm an expert, I'm a diplomat, I'm working in the embassy, I have 5 cars and 10 maids. No. I'm from Holland. These people are different.
Maar ik product zeker haar helaas naar beneden. Hi everyone, my name is Yvonne. I'm from the Netherlands and I'm married with a Sri Lankan husband. I live here 15 years and I'm the owner of an online decoration company called Farm Deco. Farm Deco is a little company for all sorts of decorations, and it's whitewashed, it's distressed, it's ideal for antique lovers. It's a wonderful concept. Before I came to Sri Lanka, I was working in the tourism sector. So I'm a tour leader for 7 countries. But because of this whole corona issue, I lost my job. So in order to get some income, I started this little online deco company. What I like about Sri Lanka is many things actually. It's the weather, the nature, culture, and I'm married with the love of my life, of course, so I love to stay here.
Yes.
And I'm a very creative, artistic person, so when I renovated our house here, I did all the things up myself. I took the time and I love the farm style. I'm from the countryside, so I'm a country girl. And when I did it all up, many people looked, came to my house and they say, wow, how wonderful is this? The concept is really nice. So that is one way I got inspired. And the second way is I see in Europe all this whitewashed stuff, this really farm style rustic furniture. And I missed that here. And I thought, wow, maybe also people like that here. So that's why I started Farm Deco. I sell my products mainly online. Online is the way to sell your products these days. So Facebook and Instagram, of course. So a lot of reactions I get back, and people start slowly ordering online. That's a new way of buying in Sri Lanka. So online is a perfect way to get your goods. And another thing is pop-up sales. I love to sell my products with the passion. I like to explain to people how I made it and what it exactly is. And people also like to interact with me about it. So I love to sell on pop-up markets as well. Delivery. Colombo is so big in the suburbs that I deliver for free. If it's very close by, that means in the Colombo area and in the small suburbs, then I can deliver with my bicycle or with the car, and I can deliver free, which is important for good customer service. Get your hands up, up.
Places to buy my raw materials, they think twice before they say the price because they want to charge me double. But I found I'm a Sri Lankan with a white skin, that's it. I found if I speak Sinhalese and I'm very respectful towards the culture and the people, they also give that back to me. I used to work in tourism and I got a good salary, to be honest. So you're used to a luxury lifestyle, and all of a sudden you fall like in a pit and you don't have anything anymore. So this corona has been for me a real a learning curve for me. And my day-to-day expenses and expenditures are not always that easy as you guys think. You think a Westerner can buy whatever she wants to buy? No! It has always been like that. Sometimes I didn't have any money. If I sold a product for 2,000 rupees, I thought, wow, I can eat another day, I can eat another 2 days.
I received a lot of support from the customers. Not only the foreigners, but also the local people loved to buy my products, and I got so much positive feedback. I mean, it was very exciting for me to see what their reaction was, and they're very positive. They absolutely love the products, and that also gives me a lot of boost to go on with this. A lot of startup companies, they cannot afford to rent for an enormous amount every day, the shop rent. So online selling and pop-up sales is an excellent way to sell your products as a new startup. And I know that a lot of women are in these businesses, and I always want to stimulate women to get on in life and to get up in life. And what my dream is actually to have a big market in the weekend where maybe 100 or 200 stalls are there, maybe after the corona, and all those women to give an opportunity to sell their beautiful products. There are so many creative people in this country, so we should all benefit from that sort of market.
So everybody has his challenges in life, but if you're positive and happy like me, you can overcome the world, no problem.
Last but not least, thank you so much, Duyo, for all the support you've given the small online businesses to come up in life, because it's not easy. I really appreciate your hard work you put into this. Stay tuned for more videos.